Joey Cassano right here representing Cassano.com. I appreciate you clicking on my video. Please subscribe. I'm trying to get that button. I don't know for my life how to get it right side up. But please subscribe, like, dislike. I'm going to give out my Super Bowl pick. Not going to give out my Super Bowl play. Never go heavy on a big game like this. You know, these two teams could play 10 times and each win 5. However, there is something a little fishy on this game. We'll talk about that later. First, let's just go over the two teams' schedules throughout the year. I'm sure most of you guys know. San Fran started the year off on the road. Pretty much skull drug Tampa Bay, skull drug Bengals. So those first two games are like JV practice games in a way. Then they play a team that's kind of legit, you know, turned out to be okay for the year. They beat Pitt at home. They destroy Baker Mayday and his Browns. And I hate Baker Mayday. I can't wait to see him on the bench. Man, he's just a horrible player, in my opinion, off and on. Then they go into the Rams, smash the Rams. Then they had a weird week against the Skins, where they only win 9-0, come out the following week, beat the brakes off of the Panthers, and then they play the Cardinals. They barely got by them. They did not cover that game. By the way, the overall record for the year for San Fran is 15-3 and 11-6 against the spread, 9-8 over and unders. Almost lost to the Cardinals. However, you have to have that look-ahead game. I always talk about that look-ahead game. They have the Seahawks the following week. And in this week of football, I want to say maybe 11, 12, Team Cassano, Moneyline Parlayed, Seattle that night against them as a six-point dog. We had the Vikings on the Sunday night before against the Cowboys. You can look up all the videos before. Like I said, I give away a ton of free picks, and most of the time I'm on the winning side. And then they beat the Cards again. They skull-drugged the Packers just the way they skull-drug them the other day. Then they lost to Baltimore 17-20, which, by the way, I want to say it was a big game for me this year, because the week before, when Baltimore skull-drug the Rams, I went triple on my unit that day and sold it as a big play. And everybody that I obviously lost on that one, we gave them the next weekend, and we told them to go big on the 49ers plus the 5.5 against the Ravens. They lose that game, but they cover the spread. Next game, I want to say, then they got the Saints the following week. Bounce back, win in New Orleans, 48-46, which after watching New Orleans this year in the postseason, I don't know if that game sounds as got as much value in it. Saints, and then they go to Atlanta, struggle with Atlanta, a little fumble-rooski kind of BS at the end. They lost that game, but anyways, that one's just kind of an end-of-the-year type game. The way it goes kind of reminds me of the way Miami beat New England last year, straight up. By the way, we were on Miami in that game, straight up against New England. Then they beat the Rams right there before Christmas, and then they beat the Seattle again. To end the season, revenge factor there. So I want to go over something with you real quick. How many postseason teams did San Fran play this year? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that is only Seahawks twice, Baltimore, Green Bay, and the Saints. The Atlanta didn't make it, the Rams didn't make it, the Cards didn't make it, the Cards didn't make it, the Panthers, the Washington, yeah. Nobody else. They only played 5 postseason teams, and one of them was twice, and that was Seattle, and they lost that one. So they are technically 4-1 against postseason teams. Now, we'll flip it over on the other side and talk about who everybody loves. Patty Mahomes, which he's legit, don't get me wrong. I love the stuff he says off the field. Handles himself way better than Baker Mayday does. Baker Mayday better start saving that money from Nissan and all those other endorsements, because he ain't going to be getting paid by any NFL team owner. So I'll flip over to KC. They started the year off pretty good, too. Overall, their record was 14-4. You know, San Fran 15-3. They were 12-5 against the spread with a push, allegedly, according to one of my sources. 6-1 on the road, 7-3 at home. Postseason, they beat the cover against the Titans last week, and then they covered against Houston the week before. Both of those two teams they played in the regular season, and both times they lost those games. Just goes to show you. Anyway, so now let's talk about KC. They beat Jacksonville. They beat Oakland. They beat Baltimore. They beat Detroit. They lost to Indy, which Indy was hot at the beginning of the year, you know, but, you know, they kind of fell off a little bit. And then they lost to Green Bay. So you got a team that skulljacks Green Bay, and then you got KC that loses to Green Bay. Don't ever cap like that or pick games like that, by the way, gentlemen. Anyways, then they beat Minnesota, another postseason team. They beat Tennessee, postseason team, 35-32. Beat the Chargers, skulljacked the Raiders, beat New England, another postseason team. And then they beat Denver, Chicago, and the Chargers to close the season out. So their postseason victories or postseason teams, they played 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And they did not lose, and they lost 1, 2. They lost two of those games that they were against postseason teams. I think, like, the point spread on this game is right on the number. Me, Team Cassano, like I said, we don't wager heavy on these big games, just like the same thing with LSU and Clemson. We didn't go big on that game. But this one here, take San Fran plus 1.5. Too many people loving the Chiefs, man. I don't know what it is. I just think San Fran's going to do it. I like John Lynch. You know, that's the top of the organization. It trickles down. And I just think San Fran is going to get the straight-up moneyline dog winner. That's the free pick for the Super Bowl. Now, you know, something's funny. You know, I used to be a bookmaker back in the day. And if you need any help on finding some action, I bet $110 a game. I'm not betting $1,000 a game. You know, I manage my bankroll as well as I can. If you need any action, definitely hit me up or my guy Wages over on Facebook. We can definitely hook you up. Guy pays out every Tuesday. Anyways, other than that, the number on this is so weird. The total, I want to say, is like 53.5, 54. I mean, didn't Kansas City score over 30 points in the last two games? You know, I mean, San Fran, didn't they score over 30 points in the last two games? I mean, Green Bay, 37-20, Vikes, 27-10. KC, they beat Houston 51-31, and then they put up 35 against the Titans. You know, it just seems a little fishy, honestly, that total. That's what we got our play on. So if you want to get in on any free picks, college basketball, been struggling a little lately this last week on some hoops, man. I had to take a few days off, really, and kind of reduce my wagers. That's what we do at Team Cassano. We try to chip away at the book, you know, slowly, slowly. No parlays. And we ask for a small reciprocal fee, you know, for the winners. We've been around doing this for a long time. Tell me why you think Kansas City's going to win. I'd love to hear the opposition, you know, but I just got a feeling San Fran. Too many people tell me they like KC. Other than that, get in touch with us if you want to get on Team Cassano's list. And then email us, Team Cassano, teamcassano.com. Other than that, I hope you gentlemen have a wonderful day. As you can tell, it's a little chillier. If you watch my videos, it's a little chillier than normal in South Florida. I don't have my door open today. But other than that, appreciate you giving me almost 10 minutes of your life. Enjoy the Super Bowl. Other than that, thank you so much.